Hey everyone, welcome back to another edition of the Pick 6. I'm your host Mike Wobschall in TCO Studios at Winter Park with a sheet full of your questions and on a 6-game winning streak. Doesn't it feel good? We have a game in like 3 days, so let's get to work. The first question comes from Thomas in the Czech Republic. What a great job by Case Keenum. His pocket movement is unbelievable. It's a really good point by Thomas. The Vikings offensive line is playing great. They haven't allowed a sack in like forever. One sack in the last 6 games, and 6 games this season that Case Keenum has played in where he hasn't been sacked. So you gotta give the O-line a ton of credit, but let's give Keenum some credit too. He does move around the pocket well, and he breaks tackles behind the line of scrimmage to buy more time and find open receivers. Really good job by Case Keenum. He's playing winning football for the Vikings. The next question comes from Ovina. The offensive line was excellent again, and Murray now appears like a power runner. Stay healthy. Well, a few things to get to here. Yes, number one, stay healthy. The Vikings offensive line, for the most part, has done that, which they didn't do last season. Mike Remmers missed the game, but Rashad Hill has filled in quite well. Offensive line, listen to these numbers. 4.9 yards per carry, 37 minutes of time of possession, 2 for 2 in the red zone and on the goal line. No sacks, 7 of 14 on third down. The offensive line is doing this with a rookie at center and a backup at right tackle and a left guard from Harvard. Great job by everyone along the offensive line, including offensive line coach Tony Sperano. The third question comes from Toby in Alaska. Wow, great performances by all against the Rams, but what is it about our halftime adjustments? We seem to be more awake or something. Well, I think the Vikings were awake for the entire game on Sunday against the Rams. Yes, Goff and company drove 9 plays, 75 yards for a touchdown to start off the game. But after that, before halftime, the Rams ended drives with a punt, a turnover, and the end of the half. 7 of the Rams' 10 drives yielded 0 or 1 first down, a truly dominant performance all game long by the Vikings. Chris in Utah has the next question. If you took Chris Carter mixed with Jake Reed and garnish it with a little Randy Moss, would that be the ingredients of wide receiver Adam Thielen's game? Well, that's pretty high praise for Adam Thielen, but guess what? He's worthy of it. Now, I'm not gonna compare him to any receivers in the past because that's not fair. Thielen is his own receiver. But what I really like about his game is his quickness, his route running, and his tenacity. He's a really good and willing run blocker on top of being a sure-handed receiver who can take the top off of defense. He's fun to watch every single week. Stefan has the next question. Another win for the good guys, all around solid, solid win. Anything you're eyeing in the Lions game that we should watch for? Well, number one, it's a short week and we're on the road, so you gotta watch the injury report. Hopefully we get some guys back and hopefully some guys who went out of the game on Sunday can play. But what we're watching for this week, the Vikings running game. It was hitting on all cylinders against the Rams, and now it goes against a Lions defense that since Haloti Ngata has been unavailable for the rest of the season, is giving up quite a few yards. First 5 games, 3.3 yards per attempt and 75 yards a game, 3 touchdowns allowed. The last 5 games, 5.3 yards attempt, 153.8 yards per game, and 9 touchdowns allowed. Maybe the Vikings can get something going on the ground this week. The final question comes from Blake in Richmond, Minnesota. When was the last time someone led the team in tackles 3 years in a row? Well, this question stems from the fact that Eric Kendricks, who's just around the 100 tackle mark already this season, he leads us in tackles, and he's done it for 2 straight years. Good start to his career for Eric Kendricks. The last Viking to lead the tackles for 3 years or more in a row was number 52, Chad Greenway. 6 straight years, Greenway was our tackling machine. 2008 to 2013, Chad was number one on the team in tackles. Eric Kendricks looks like he's a player who could put together a similar streak. He's a lot of fun to watch. Speaking of a lot of fun to watch, Vikings mic'd up slash wired players, and we had one on Sunday against the Rams, and it's, oh, just the guy who scored 2 touchdowns, Latavius Murray. That's coming up this week on Vikings.com, so stay tuned for that. Also, we'll be back with another edition of the Pick 6 next week, so send your questions in to the email address at the bottom of the screen, and we'll see you then.